Hola, muy buenas a todos. Estoy aquí con Jason Schiemann de Bitcoin.com, que nos estará contando este fabuloso dominio. Jason, welcome, and you're speaking for all Latin America, all Spain, a bunch of crazy crypto Spanish people, and of course, you know, it would be great for you to share with us a little bit about Bitcoin.com, what you guys do, and in what do you believe. And I ask you a little bit about some questions later. So
okay, so I think we were just talking about it a moment ago.
Yeah.
That Bitcoin.com maybe is a really good entry point for people who are looking
for beginners.
Yeah, for beginners, but also for people coming back to the space and trying to keep up with what's going on. So we have news. We have a wallet which allows you to use your first Bitcoin. And we have a mining pool where some people, if they want to get into mining but not buy all the physical equipment, you can get into our cloud mining. And we also have games on our website. So,
good, yeah. Good. This is, of course, you guys were some of the pioneers. This is going way too fast. For some people, it's like, it's way too late. And some other people, it's just the beginning. How's your vision mm-hmm. of everything happening with Bitcoin, with Bitcoin Cash, with all the altcoins? Mm-hmm. ICOs, it seems like this is going at 2,000 miles per hour.
Yeah, so I guess there's a lot going on, but there's a lot of good things going on. There's a lot of people who are working on the infrastructure or applications that like move the system forward. And I think you said maybe being too late. I don't know exactly, like, well, too late for what?
Because well, now, people are saying, oh, it's too late to buy Bitcoin.
Yeah. If you're constantly focused on the price and stuff, then that can be really scary, I guess. But if you're involved in making a usable Bitcoin and something that you think can be used to make the world a better place, then it's definitely not too late. We're in the beginning of it and things are getting better. It's a lot easier. So I think people who tried to maybe buy Bitcoin a few years ago, myself, trying to do an OTC transaction, that is scary,
yeah.
Right? So giving your money to someone you don't know, or just dealing with UIs in the past, it was very, very complicated, but we see it getting easier and easier day by day. So when you focus on the Bitcoin space, and namely what we see with developments in Bitcoin Cash, then I think that it's a good time, right?
Okay, telling us a little bit about Bitcoin Cash.
Yeah.
People still, people get a little confused.
Yeah.
I see my opinion. I see Bitcoin like as something like gold that people are gonna storage, mm-hmm. that people are not gonna use it. And I see more Bitcoin Cash like cash.
Okay.
What's your vision between Bitcoin and Bitcoin Cash?
Well, with Bitcoin Cash, I guess the argument would be that if you could have something that could be a store of value and that could also be used as cash, then that is obviously better. And now what we're seeing is, when at the end of last year we saw a huge spike in Bitcoin and everyone got very excited, but also at the same time the mempool got filled up and there were some people who were trying to move their Bitcoin or maybe get
it
to
an exchange. Yeah, it was like $500 fee,
yeah.
It was just crazy.
So, or you didn't pay enough and your Bitcoin was stuck, right? So, I mean, if you want to talk about Bitcoin Cash versus Bitcoin, I think people have talked about that quite a bit. It's pretty clear what the difference is right now with how it can be used. With, you're not going to run into an issue with the mempool being full right now with Bitcoin Cash, but people are just free to choose whatever they want and people are going to choose what works. And we still are in the early stages where Bitcoin was the first one to the market, I guess, or BTC was the first one to the market.
Yeah.
But it doesn't mean that there isn't something that could come along that's quite a bit better, and people just make their choice with where they want to hold their money. And if something's more usable, there's a better community around it, then it seems kind of obvious what the choice is there.
Okay. And a few advices for beginners, for people that are mm-hmm. putting their first step into this arena?
It depends what area you're getting into. Our CEO, who's very well known, Roger Ver, he says, don't put all your eggs in one basket, and I think that is amazing advice. And another thing is, if you are looking to get into some of these, some of these ICOs, then just try, just do your research, and don't, you're gonna, if your goal is to make a lot of money, yeah, you're going to miss out on some, but you know, that's, if you get caught up in that mentality, you could probably do some damage to yourself. So just do what research you can, diversify, try and learn, and yeah, with some of these, there's going to be some ICOs that come along that are going to do quite well, but then some you're going to see kind of get washed out because maybe they don't have the strong team to back up what they're saying. So.
And a few last questions, like, how do you see the future? In my opinion, probably the government, they will try to create official cryptocurrencies like the crypto euro or the crypto dollar or the crypto yen. They're probably not under those names, but they're going to have probably some official cryptocurrency, and there's going to be some others. Like, how do you see the transition between what we call the fiat world and the crypto world? That right now they're navigating kind of like in a separate way.
Yeah, so I mean, trying to bundle all the governments together and saying what they're going to decide and whether or not I would want to put money into a yen crypto or a dollar crypto, that's a little bit difficult to say. So it's a pretty broad question, but I think if you just focus on governments wanting to do crypto, I don't think if it reduces overhead, if it increases transparency, where if that's one thing that comes out of blockchain, where people can actually understand monetary policy, because right now, if
it's a black box,
yeah, it's very difficult to understand, right? So if that allows people, like it gives them that information, I think that's a positive thing. Would I necessarily trust a specific government, like, and their intention with how that crypto was run? I guess I'd have to do my research with that particular crypto, right?
Good. So. Okay, and then this is early, but maybe in the beginning of July, something very important is going to happen for all the Spanish community. What are we going to do? maybe.
Well, I mean, we are in Tokyo right now, and it's unfortunate that we couldn't, I guess, speak with Roger.
With Roger.
And he really wanted to be here, and he wanted to meet all these people because some people are working on some pretty exciting projects. But hopefully we can figure out something via web conference, and then if we confirm that, we can tack that onto the end of this video and give you some real information there.
Perfect. Okay. So pay attention and hear from the Japan Blockchain 2018 with Jason.
Okay.
Bye-bye. ¿Todavía no conoces nuestros programas? Iker, léeme la carta.
Curso online, programa avanzado, trading con criptomonedas y programa Ultimate.
Te harán conseguir grandes rentabilidades. Visita formacionencriptomonedas.com.